Hey everybody, it's Friday evening and I have not had a lot of time to get anything done down here in the fish room today, so today's video is going to simply be feeding video of Butterbean here. I'm going to throw a small handful of snails in there and it shouldn't take him too long to figure out that they've just been thrown in there, and I can see him making his way around from the back now. So give him a few moments and he'll figure out those snails are in there. Or at least he should. Maybe I might have to go get one more and throw it in there just so he sees them go in and he knows they're in there. It shouldn't take him too long to realize it. Sometimes if I actually come over to the glass and I point and he sees that my finger's down here, he'll sort of know I've put food in the tank, and then he'll come over here and investigate. So let's see if he doesn't come over and investigate now that he's been spooked. But I have made him aware that I was over there, so let's see if he doesn't come and investigate a little more rather than pacing the glass the way he was. In the meantime, I'm going to go grab another snail just in case. Sees me throw it in, he'll know it's in there. Now I believe he just saw that one go in and he's over there looking for it now. Yeah, he spotted it, he's eyeballing it up. Hey everybody, this is my figure eight puffer Butterbean having his snails for dinner. I had tried to get the video set up where we were gonna, you know, get to see the snails get introduced into the tank and we were gonna get to see him cruising around and hunting for them. And he was just acting so contrary tonight. Every time I would come near him, he would go in the back of the tank and he would pace the glass and hide from me. Every time I got the camera out, he would like turn around and swim away almost as though he knew what I was trying to do and he was just trying to prevent me from getting a video. And finally, after about 15 minutes, I just got frustrated and I just left the room. And when I came back, he was eating all the snails. I know he knew they were in there. It wasn't as though he, you know, didn't see me put the snails in, and he even came over and checked a few of them out, and then as soon as I picked the camera up, he swam away from them because apparently he was more interested in not being on video than he was in eating his dinner. So while I've got you here and I've got you all zoomed in close up like this, notice how there's that sort of reddish brown material on the bottom. You can see that there's some light gray substrate, then there's that sort of darker substrate that looks a little more aged in back where Butterbean is, and then up here more towards the front and over here you can see all that reddish material. That's that red cyanobacteria coming back. I got a lot of it out of there in the last water change, but it's still growing back in sheets again. So it looks like I'm gonna have to treat this tank with the Ultralife aquarium treatment again. I'm sorry, not the Ultralife, the ChemiClean. The Ultralife is what I used before, and I used that for the blue-green slime. And the ChemiClean I always thought was for using in brackish and marine environments, which it may very well be designed for that, but I have found that it works very well in freshwater environments too, and I always use that now rather than the Ultralife. The Ultralife was okay, but the ChemiClean just wipes out all of the scum and stuff you've got growing in your tank. So this tank's been up and running for quite a while without any problems with the bacteria at all, but it's clearly having problems with the bacteria now. And since it's in there, you know, I can try vacuuming it out all I want. I've been playing this game in this brackish tank for years and years and years, and I just know how it goes. Where, you know, now that it's in this tank, basically the only way to get it out of this tank is to strip this tank down and start it over. So before it gets bad, I'm going to go ahead and do a ChemiClean treatment. So probably starting later tonight, this tank's going to have an air stone in it and a bubbler, and that's all part of the treatment. You know, the instructions are right on the package if you actually get the ChemiClean product, and I will put a link below if you're interested in getting it. It works by oxidation, so you've got to have maximum gas exchange as possible in your tank. So you've got to have a good vigorous air stone bubbling, good water circulation, and as long as you've got all that and as long as you follow the instructions and do it, you know, properly, I find it to be really effective. Now, it'll be interesting to see what happens in this tank, because this will be the first time I've actually used it in the brackish aquarium. I've used it in my freshwater aquariums, and I've always had really, really good success with them. It's cleaned the tanks, and I've not had to go back and clean again later. But that has never been for this red cyanobacteria, and it's never been in a saltier or a higher specific gravity environment as we're going to be doing in this tank. This tank has a specific gravity. I usually keep it around 1.005, but occasionally it gets up to about 1.008. So it fluctuates around in there, and it'll be interesting to see if I do treat with the Ultralife this time, will I actually get good results where it's gone and doesn't come back almost immediately. When I've used the other stuff before, you know, as soon as it was done, it was just growing back almost immediately. So I'm going to have to go. I've just been informed that my battery is just about dead, and if it cuts off mid-record, then I lose the whole video. So we're going to go ahead and end it here since Butterbean has gone to the back of the tank anyway. So I am going to say thank you for watching. Make sure you're subscribed. You don't want to miss anything else I got coming up. I will be working on this tank in the very near future. Don't forget, this one is my brackish tank. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you real soon on the next one.